worse. I could see the show today. We're in Cologne and we got rained out again and again and again. Fingers crossed that we're gonna do it today, cause we're gonna leave here today too.
Just been dodging rain the whole trip. It's been pretty gnarly.
Definitely the busiest spot. Look how many people there were.
It's at the main train station in town. There's a cathedral where all the tourists go all day, every day.
So many people, and they just kept getting in the way. They would sit on like the top stair. He started trying the back 360 kickflip and eventually was sticking every single one of them.
One of the many tricks Chris has pretty dialed, and he was sticking every one, so we just expected he was going to make it.
He got super close, but he tweaked his ankle, so that was bad.
Yeah, that was out of nowhere. I tried to bail, landed back on it. He never gets hurt. He's like trying to touch it. Just speaking in German of it. Can't even understand him. He's just trying to help, but not helping.
He decided to come back, or everybody decided you have to come back for sure for that.
Chris happened to be in Germany 1 year later for a contest, so we arranged to meet him in Cologne. We only had a couple of days in town before we had to go on another Etnies tour, so time was precious, and unfortunately it rained most of the time we were there, so it came down to the last day.
Yeah, here we are, a year later after the rolled ankle. And the day I tried it, we actually were like, had these guys like, power washing the floor and the ground, you know, like the spot. So we had to like ask them for like an extra 5 minutes, and that's why in the rollaway I have to ollie over an extension cord, because that was the extension cord that came to their power washer. But they were super cool. They let me get like an extra 5 minutes and stuff. So
you typically want to get there early in the morning to try and beat the crowds, but no matter what time you go, it's always hectic. So there's security that comes by all the time, so you have to kind of dodge those guys. Before we could even start skating, they gave us a warning. Willow was trying to talk to them, but they were talking about giving us tickets, so we were always looking over our shoulder throughout the session. To be honest, the first few tries weren't looking that good. It wasn't like a year before where he was sticking every one of them. They were kind of loose and not catching them. There was a couple of times actually where Chris would sit down and hide away from the security as they did their laps around and then get back up and try.
It was only like actually 8 tries, I think, like total that morning.
And then out of nowhere, the first one he caught landed and rode away.
The ollie over the cord kind of surprised me too.
See, it's the whole project, his last trick and one trick. It's just the energy and the vibes and how much effort he put in there.
Yes, you hear me as they're laughing. It's awesome. Can't believe Willow caught my shirt too. Like, man, that's sick.
It's just such a memorable moment that it seemed like a good way to end his part and the video.
When they picked this for the ender, I was like, that makes complete sense. For the ender of my part, at least. I didn't even like think about it as the end of the video. Like, that's crazy. Damn, that just made me realize that. Like, I realized it was the end of my part, but then I always thought like, oh, credits come next. But damn, that's like the end of the video.